Nikolai Borisovich, Mr. Vladimir Rolofovich, who is the chairman of BelCCI, Honorable Dennis Morris, Deputy Minister of Energy, Shehzad Sabir Sahab, Vice President of Federation of Pakistan Chamber of Commerce and Industry, businessmen from both Pakistan and Belarus. Good morning once again, and thank you very much for providing me the opportunity to speak to the audience today. Much has been already said about Pakistan-Belarus relations, having 80 plus MOUs and agreements providing all kinds of platform for interaction between the two countries, excellent political ties between Pakistan and Belarus, growing business ties. This year already there is a positive trajectory of our exports and imports from Belarus, and increased number of high level as well as business to business engagements during this year despite COVID-19 situation. It's a matter of great pleasure for me that, you know, in the month of February this year we had a useful business day at the BelCCI, and which was attended by over 100 Belarusian companies. Followed by that, we had the fourth session of business forum virtually on 11th of April between the FPCCI and BelCCI, and which was after a gap of almost 4 years. I think the third session was held in 2017. Same month, in the month of April, we had two trade delegations from Pakistan visiting Belarus, and subsequently in May also we had Bel Agro exhibition held here, in which a trade delegation headed by the Federal Secretary of Pakistan was here to attend. A series of engagements on the military sites, including the Defense Production Minister, who was here for a 9 days long visit and holding different kinds of meetings with all stakeholders, and the Joint Commission of Military and Technical Cooperation, and senior level engagements at the military, defense to defense ministry level, all have been held during this year despite the COVID situation. Today, while both countries are still facing the situation, there is a rise of COVID cases both in Belarus as well as in Pakistan. The presence of over 60 participants from Pakistan reflects the desire of Pakistan to expand trade cooperation with Belarus. It's gratifying to see that over 100 Belarusian partners are here, and I'm sure that today's this interaction will provide further impetus to the much needed trade expansion, both in terms of export and import, as well as joint venture, which was mentioned by the Honorable Deputy Foreign Minister. We are very happy that in the coming months, the Defense Minister of Belarus is visiting Pakistan, the Foreign Minister of Belarus is visiting Pakistan, and the Joint Commission is also scheduled end of the year. And with all these engagements, I'm very positive that in the coming years, we will have much better results to reflect, and much more, optimistic outcome, which we can, inshallah, see in the future. I thank you all once again, and the Embassy of Pakistan will be here to provide any kind of support. Recently, we have established a expo center, not a big scale, but a very small display center within the embassy, providing all kinds of samples, including of textile and pharmaceutical and leather, as well as this work-related, construction-related. Those samples are available. So any businessman from Belarus wishing to explore further are most welcome to the Embassy of Pakistan in the course of the days, as per your convenience. And the embassy will be, of course, ready to provide any kind of assistance to the Pakistani businessmen who would like to enter the Belarusian market. So it's very happy situation that the Belarusian side is very forthcoming, and we do not see any kind of issues in expanding our trade and investment ties. So once again, thank you all for coming, and wish you all a very successful day and successful outcome. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. Thank you. Again.